Hello, Internet. Long time no see. Although, if I want to be a creeper about it, I suppose you could say that I've seen you, you just haven't seen me. Anyway, I normally have a bit of difficulty finding inspiration for the vlogs, as much as I love it, but I thought I would come on here today because I found a bit of inspiration. Actually, I found a bit of aggravation, which is unusual for me. Normally, I am a very, you know, easygoing kind of person. I can see both sides of any argument. You can be telling me the sky is blue, and I can turn around and say, like, yes, but isn't it also any color but blue? Which was my attempt at a biology joke, and don't know if I got that right. Sorry, nerds. Anyway, some of you may not be surprised when you hear that the thing I took umbrage against was found on Fox News. And now you can find plenty of detractors for Fox News anywhere on the internet, as you can with anything on the internet. It's one of the reasons why it's so awesome. But, yeah. I've heard a lot of disparaging comments regarding Fox News, most centering around their political affiliations or their response to some kind of hot-button issue, which, you know, during a presidential campaign as we're in right now, isn't that surprising. Tempers can get flared very easily, especially within your opposition. My thoughts today, though, have nothing to do with the politics, which are usually at the root of that anger. Today, I would just like to address the manner in which Fox News discussed the existence of asexuality on their recent segment of Red Eye. The topic of discussion was inspired by a book called Understanding Asexuality by Anthony F. Bogart, and opened up with an interesting quote cited to Michael Dore during a World Pride conference, I'm not sure which year, which read, "We want asexuality to be recognized as a valid sexual orientation rather than a disorder or something to hide." Directly after the introduction of the topic, the segment host affirms the existence of such ignorance by asking if his co-panelists bought the belief or the existence of asexuality. She responded in kind with a joke that said she did in fact believe that asexuality existed. It's called being a woman. Every 3.5 weeks when you're trying to get out of certain obligations. Well, that short exchange was disrespectful and disturbing in its implications and would set the tone for the remainder of the discussion. Despite the original expectation I had that this was going to be a discussion about the facts regarding asexuality, no additional information was addressed. In fact, the only statistic quoted from the book, an estimate that roughly 1% of the population identified as asexual, was very quickly suggested to be an exaggeration. Actually, it was compared to exaggerating the population of pixies, which I didn't make that up. They used the word pixie. Like pixies, the panelists immediately stated that asexuality was an invention of those trying to explain away normal men who didn't want to have sex 10 times a day. And I'm sorry for the air quotes, but their attitudes were cruel and dismissive. This wasn't a debate of human sexuality or even an objective explanation of a social phenomenon. This was a professed news channel abandoning any semblance of professionalism to mock a portion of the population for no other reason than that they profess to be different. What followed was a progression of jokes and thoughtless comments, which would have been inappropriate for a schoolyard, let alone a group of adults on national TV, with an unfortunately large following of people who depend on them for their news and for their outlook on the world. These jokes included ones such as comparing the recognition of such a small percentage of the population with having to recognize every person who wore a sock monkey hat, or else the implication that asexuality was adequately represented by the SNL skit Pat, apparently confusing asexuality with androgyny, which has its own implications regarding their understanding of the topic. And then there was the philosophically profound imagining of the most boring beer commercial ever, with nary a buxom bikini-clad babe to be found. But for me, the most telling line of discussion came at the end of the segment, when the host, I'm afraid whose name escapes me, said, "Now, when someone wants to be recognized, you got to wonder, what do they want? And then you have to ask yourself, well, what are they not getting?" Of course, the immediate response provided was that, well, you know they're not after sex, to which everyone laughed, and it's pretty funny. I mean, what else could they possibly want? Anyway, it's just my opinion that this is not the way you treat fellow human beings. It's certainly not the way you treat them at home, and it's definitely not how you should be treating them when you are a trusted source of information and those who we rely on to not only deliver us objective information, but to provide a rational and cogent discussion of events which could affect us. Anyone looking for more information about asexuality should check out AVEN, which is the Asexuality Visibility and Education Network, at asexuality.org. And also, I'm going to include that link in the description and another link which, not that I'm expecting it, but if anyone from Fox News should wander by, this is an example of how you have done it better and how you should have done it better. Anyway, it's just how I viewed it, and let's hope that with a bit more rational discussion we can help prevent this kind of careless treatment of our fellow human beings and hopefully decrease a bit of world suck. Anyway, I hope you're having a good day. Love you all. Best wishes.